Well, hey, it's Dr. Scott. I'm here with your week six, how to do better on the reading video, a pre-video before you start in on part two of Crazy Brave. And by the way, I think that the advice I'm giving you will also work really well when we get to How a Mountain Was Made, which is the next book that we read after this one. So this is good stuff. Of course, I'm still grading your Poet X and I'll get there. I'm working on it, but this, like I say, this will work for both Crazy Brave and How a Mountain Was Made, because a lot of this has to do with how to read Native American literature. And both of these authors, Greg Saris and Joy Harjo, are world famous Native American authors, not from the same tribe, but from the same generation. In fact, they're even friends in the real world. Okay, so how can you do this better? A couple of ideas. Number one, I really want to say again, and I know I sound like I keep repeating this, if there's any way for you to afford the $12.99 version of the audiobook, I think it is so worthwhile. It's literally Joy Harjo reading her own story. Unlike the Poet X, this is not a made-up fictional story. This is a real story of a real person who is a real survivor and really is the Poet Laureate of the U.S. last year and all that kind of cool stuff. I'm just going to play some of it for you, as a matter of fact, just a little so you get a sample. I think this could transform your experience of the book.
My mother's singing attracted me to her road in this world. It is her song that lit my attention as I listened in the ancestor realm. Secret longing rose up in her heart as she sang along with the radio. The music threading the atmosphere in what was known as Tulsa, Oklahoma, or T-Town in 1951, with songs for falling in love, songs for falling out of love, songs to endure the purgatory of longing, or improvisational swing jazz, country, or songs just for the sake of kicking it.
Okay, now already in that teeny little clip, we get to the second part of my advice, which is that Joy Harjo, like many Native American authors, switches back and forth between the real world, Tulsa, Oklahoma, she's a young child, et cetera, et cetera. And basically what's sort of a dream or mythic world, which is very real to her. And this often happens on the same page. So a second little piece of advice is maybe take a page like this. This is page 30 from the last chapter. And I was showing one student in my office hour, maybe you could use a yellow highlighter on that page for when she's writing about the real world, and orange highlighter when she sort of switches into this dreamtime world. And I know you've all had dreams like this. You've dreamed about lives that you haven't physically lived. You might have even had dreams about who you were before you were born, or who your mother was, you know, what your mother was doing before. Many Native cultures do this. I just happen to have this book on my shelf, Australian Dreaming. And what that means is that in Aboriginal Australia culture, which is 40,000 years old, unimaginably old, at least 40,000 years old, they literally think that there's a simultaneous world that exists at all times and all places for them, and they call it dream time. So in a way, Joy Harjo, although she's from a completely different culture, is telling you about her dream time world. And you need to see when she's shifting back and forth, and sometimes it's in italics and sometimes it's not. So use your highlighters to figure that out. Now, in terms of Joy Harjo not being, say, Australian, or Catholic, I mean, because Catholics think that there's simultaneously a heaven and a hell and the Trinity and all of that. I mean, and again, I mean this very respectfully, spiritual traditions recognize that there's a separate and parallel reality. So since I don't think most of you know much about Creek Muskogee culture, and Joy Harjo is Creek Muskogee, that's one of hundreds of different tribal cultures in North America, hundreds. So just because we say Indian or Native American, that's hundreds of different things. You could look up, say, Creek mythology in the Wikipedia and read it. And I'm not even gonna send you the link, because you can go wiki, Creek mythology, Creek meaning Creek Native American tribe who are originally from the southeastern United States. They tell you a little bit of the history, which I'm about to tell you about too, but here's a little bit on the Creek creation myth. And in the Poet X, you had to read about the Christian creation story, which is called Genesis, and Adam and Eve, and is Eve really made out of Adam's rib, which actually Shiomara doesn't agree with, at least initially, although she comes back to her religion later in the book, blah, blah, blah. So the point is, you've had to deal with this in a Christian context. Now you need to deal with it in the terms of Native American spirituality. And just doing some very basic Googling to find out that the Creek believed that there was that the world was originally entirely underwater. The only land was a hill called Nunachaha, on which was the home of the master of breath, a solar deity. In the same way that Genesis starts with in the beginning, the world was out form and void. And in the beginning was the word. So in the beginning here was breath. These things can really help you understand what's going on. So a third way to help yourself understand what's going on would be to learn more about Muscogee Creek culture. And so I looked up the Muscogee Creek Nation. They are an independent nation. They have their own website. And so let's ask the Muscogee Creek people who they are. And what you'll find out is that Muscogee Creek people are descendants of a remarkable culture that before 1500 AD, so 1500 years ago, Middle Ages in Europe, spanned the entire region known today as the southeastern United States. Early ancestors of the Muscogee, so that means the whole south part, what we now call the South, was inhabited by her people. They constructed magnificent earth pyramids along the rivers. You know about the pyramids in Egypt. You probably don't know about the pyramids in North America, for one thing, because they were eroded and then covered with forests after they made contact with European peoples, which caused massive pandemics, like the current COVID pandemic, grim as it is. And I know many of you are suffering and have lost family members, but the death rate is well under 10% with COVID, even well under 10% of the population. The pandemic that struck the Creek Muscogee Nation when there was contact with European civilizations after Columbus, after Cortez, after the initial Spanish explorations into North America, they lost like 90 to 95% of their entire tribal population. It's kind of unimaginable how you would survive that. And yet, people like Joy Harjo are survivors of that. They are also survivors of the forced removal from their own lands by the United States government, who sent them to what is now Oklahoma. That's not where the Creek Muscogee people were originally. That was not their original homeland. So they have been uprooted along what she literally calls the Trail of Tears, right? And there were many trails of many tears. And so you could read more about that here. And again, where I'm getting this information, which I hope you'll read for yourself, is from the Muscogee Creek Nation's own website. And you can look it up just as well as I can. So I'm just gonna let you do that. A fifth place to get help would be to look at more videos. I hope you did take me seriously and watch the video interview, 7 minutes, that I posted last week. But here's one with Oprah. And Oprah's trying to talk to her about the spiritual realm and saying, I too, Oprah, although I'm not Native American, have similar ideas, so I'm gonna play you some.
In this beautiful memoir, Crazy Brave, about how your mother's music allowed you to enter and you were called by the music. Do you remember it?
I remember, I had a rough birth.
Yes.
Yes. So it wasn't a real easy birth. It was, I kind of fought for 2 days and they didn't think I would live. So I have that kind of, I know that I struggled, but I can't remember. I can remember being an infant, moments of being an infant, and remembering that I struggled with even wanting to stay here as an infant. Yes, because it seemed everything, I could feel everything. And it's not just me, all children feel everything.
Yes, I know that.
And the burden of it. And I thought, how am I going to move through this? And it felt like too much.
Yes, you know, it's interesting. All those years of talking to so many people during the Oprah show, I came to understand that we all come in to the birth space trailing the breath of the angels. We all come in knowing, mm-hmm. and we all come in with that knowing. And depending on where you are and what your culture is, you lose it quickly. And some cultures more quickly than others, because even when you are still in touch with that other world, people tell you, oh, no, you're not.
Okay, now, Oprah's saying that she gets it, and also that she's felt this, and that many cultures feel this. So I hope you'll watch the rest of this little interview too. It's a really great one. And there's actually, it's a lengthy interview. It's not just 3 minutes long. This is just a little teeny 3 minute clip. So you can, so maybe Oprah would help you understand. So let's put all these things together and just sort of wrap up. First of all, please do think about getting the audiobook. You can even get it for free. You can get your first Audible audiobook for free. Now, they do want your credit card and they think you're going to buy a whole lot more, but it could be done. I hope you'll figure out a way to do that. Second, looking up Creek mythology, Creek spirituality, knowing a little bit about what Creek people believe because you're reading a Creek author, just like you need to know a little bit about what Catholics believe. Even if you're not Catholic at all, like me, I still need to know something about Catholicism to understand what Shiomara is talking about. You need to understand a little bit of what Creeks are about, and that also includes their history. So ask them, right? So read a little bit here. Finally, think about this and many, many other videos about Joy Harjo that are available online. This is just one of many. In fact, I think if I back up here, I should get to another page that has, like, look how many videos when I say Joy Harjo and I type that into my YouTube search engine, look how many videos there are. Now, obviously you don't have time to look at all of these, but just like looking at a little piece of them can really be a powerful thing. Okay, and then finally using your highlighters with the book, so that when she moves from one realm into the other, from the physical realm into the spiritual realm, you're sort of catching it on the page. Hope that part two of the book, our second, I guess, direction, right? We read East last week, and this week we are reading, I can't remember, and I won't get it wrong, North. So as you go north, I hope that these help you navigate through this wonderful space.